In this paper, we are discussing about dual regression networks for single image super resolution. In the super resolution problem, when we are taking a low resolution image and when we are mapping to the network, we are getting the high resolution output. But here in this paper, they are mentioning that the equivalent high resolution images for that low resolution image may be many. Example, if I am taking a high resolution image 1, high resolution image 2, high resolution image 3. When I downsample these three high resolution images, we may get the same low resolution image. Means whatever the low resolution image we are taking for the super resolution, we may have the chance that multiple number of high resolution images may come as output. We cannot detect which is our correct output. Second problem is, generally we take the high resolution image and we downgrade it to get the low resolution image. This training pair we will give to the network, and because of that it is a train, and whenever we give the test image, we get the high resolution image. The pairing, whatever the training sample we are giving, the low resolution image and high resolution image, we are getting a low resolution image from the existing high resolution image by using the downgrading. But in real sense, in the real world, the data do not necessarily have the same distribution to the LR images. So we are actually not taking the real time low resolution and high resolution training sample. We are taking a high resolution image, from that we are downgrading it and we are giving it as a training example. So in this sense, whatever the high resolution image we are getting for the test example, that might not be the real one in the existing scenario. In this paper, they are proposing a dual regression scheme. In this dual regression scheme, they are downsampling the high resolution image and the low resolution image, which is downsampled from the high resolution image, they are giving parallelly for the input. This is what they are doing in the dual regression task. In the primal regression task, they are finding a function p, which is mapping from x to y. This x is a low resolution image and this y is a high resolution image. Now, we are predicting an image p of x, which is very similar to original output y. Similarly, in the dual regression task, here what they have proposed, we are using a function d, which is mapping from y to x. Here y is high resolution image and x is low resolution image. And this function d is mapping from y to x, where x is the low resolution image. Here, whatever the prediction we are getting, we are calling d of y. This is almost similar to our low resolution image. Means previously we used to predict the high resolution image, which is close to y. And now we are also doing the second task. We are predicting a low resolution image, which is close to x. We use this predicted low resolution image along with the low resolution image in order to improve the high resolution image output. So these two tasks, primal regression task, which we are using for the prediction of high resolution output, and a dual regression task, which we are using to predict the low resolution input from the corresponding high resolution output, these two tasks are forming closed loop. So until now, we used to consider only one loss, that is due to the difference between the predicted super resolution output and the original super resolution. Now we are also calculating the loss for the dual regression task, means the difference between the predicted low resolution image and the original low resolution image. So these two loss are combinedly giving the entire loss. Now the problem with the existing SR models is they do not know what to do with the unpaired data. means if we are giving that kind of image for which there is no training output in the training data set, if that particular type of image was not there, if we did not train by using that particular image, then we do not know what is the predicted output for that image, because we have not trained the network with that image. We are calling that type of data as unpaired data, means we have the low resolution image, but we do not know what is its corresponding high resolution image, because this low resolution image we are taking from the live data, maybe the YouTube video which is being streamed now. For that, we do not know what is there in that video. That is the low resolution image. We are taking one frame. For that frame, we do not know what is the high resolution output. For such type of real data, this dual regression task can be implemented. In such type of problem, by using the low resolution image, this network predicts a high resolution image. But for the quality purpose, that high resolution image is downsampled, and we are giving again the low resolution image. This low resolution, we are checking whether this downsampled low resolution image is similar to our original low resolution image or not. After that, we are improving this. This is happening in a closed loop manner until we get a very good quality of high resolution image. This is the primal regression task. They have used the convolution layer, and then leaky ReLU, and again convolution. After that, by using the unit structure, we are doing the primal regression task. The dual regression task, you can observe here, again, they are giving this high resolution image as a feedback to input. Means we are downsampling the high resolution image and we are giving the low resolution image as a feedback to input in order to get a very good high quality output. For training the paired data, we are using the supervised method, supervised learning technique. And for training the unpaired data, we are using the existing unsupervised learning techniques in order to train. They have mentioned with their proposed model for the data sets set 5, set 14, and for these data sets, they are getting a very good signal to noise, peak signal to noise ratio PSNR, and the SSIM values, which we use as a matrix in order to know whether the high resolution output is a very good quality or not. Compared to the existing methods, this method is giving a very good PSNR and SSIM values.